Today, at a small ceremony near Southend, about 50 veterans of the Second World War met for their annual VJ Day ceremony, marking the Allies' victory against Japan in 1945. Their inevitable sorrow at recalling thousands of comrades who died in the Far East, many in appalling conditions, is matched by a determination to get compensation for those who survived and for the families of those who perished. Now, the Essex-based group campaigning for compensation says it's finally nearer its aim. Dave Brewer reports.
Today's small service was, as in previous years, a chance for the survivors of the war to remember the dead. But it also marked the latest stage in the fight for adequate compensation for those held in the camps and the families of those who died. Already, American servicemen have been paid more than £13,000, the Canadians, £10,000. The British servicemen say they should be paid a similar amount.
We are after a recognition and compensation from the Japanese government, not the British government or British taxpayer. We want the Japanese to recognise what they did to us in the Second World War and to compensate us accordingly. Now, for argument's sake, our widows receive £50 a week less than the widows of the Falklands Islands issue and also Northern Ireland, the chaps who were killed there. Our widows get £50 a week less. Now, we don't begrudge them a penny, but we say that they've all got to live in the same world.
The Southend-based Japanese Labour Camp Survivors Association is at the forefront of the effort to win compensation. One of them is Ernie Warwick, who's written a book detailing what he says is the true story of what went on. He's highlighted cases of cruelty, similar to the one that left him wheelchair-bound.
I think the very least they could do is pay each person £10,000 as a minimum of respect, but in point of fact, no amount of money will compensate for what's gone before, but at least it would be something. It would help people like myself, and there's plenty like me, and there's plenty that cannot be here today, blind, in homes, crippled and paralysed, resulting from their unfortunate experiences of Japanese prison. And it must surely help them in some measure in their old age if the Japanese government were to suddenly say, well, OK, we ought to do this. We're ashamed of our past.
The survivors now have the support of more than 200 MPs in their campaign for compensation. They've won the backing of the United Nations and human rights campaigners and say it's only a matter of time before the Japanese authorities have to recognise their responsibilities.